pay for movie tickets.
Or in music.
Yeah, but you're buying a product. That's the thing. So we've been discussing Patreon. I got my first Patreon patron contributor. I immediately realized I didn't ever knew what Patreon was. I thought Patreon worked hand in hand with YouTube and that the subscribers on YouTube and the viewership on YouTube was integrated into Patreon, but it's a basically standalone platform. And then I realized I don't think I want to accept Patreon
donations.
Why? When money changes hands, it changes the nature of a relationship. I private messaged the guy who, my first Patreon patron, and then I said, I realize I don't want people paying me for the content, I just want them to enjoy watching it. Potential Patreon patrons are either going to be financially less well off than me, or they're going to be financially better off than me. If the person is financially less well off than me, I would feel embarrassed taking any money so that I could live doing what I'm doing. If they're financially better off than me, I don't necessarily want them feeling that they are owed something as a result of their contribution. Yes.
There's just one thing.
Yes.
YouTube doesn't make you enough money to survive.
One lemonade stand of economics, and now you realize that our life is in a precarious financial state. The other thing is, when someone gives money, it creates, on the one hand, a sense of guilt in the person receiving it, that would be me, and it creates, potentially, a sense of control in the person giving it. Even going to Jack Conte's explanation as to what motivated him to create Patreon, it goes back to, like, the days of the ancient days of art, when famous artists were commissioned by people to create art. Even when they were commissioned by people, huh? Like how? Even when people were commissioned by the wealthy to produce art, there was an element of control by the wealthy person who was commissioning the artist. Yes.
There's nothing wrong with it.
I didn't say there's anything wrong with it. I said it makes me feel uncomfortable to some extent, and it changes the nature of our relationship. This relationship is not to be one of expectations of payment or receiving. No, it creates cool lighting.
But you support someone.
I support someone. I support the Gregory Brothers Shmoyoho on Patreon, and I don't mind it. I have no expectation in return, and I know that for the amount I'm giving them, they don't have any reasonable expectation from me.
Why do you think that would be different for other people?
I would feel that it would be different for other people. It's probably in my head, but it would probably... No, I may be crazy, but it would affect the way I do things. Let's just say, hypothetically, someone decides to sponsor me for...
any amount of money.
I would feel that I might be letting them down based on their expectations of the content if I were to produce stuff that they didn't like
then
on Patreon.
Supporting you.
But then I'd be insulted. Someone on YouTube said something that they didn't like Patreon because it created a sort of a transactional relationship between the parties. And he's right and he's wrong. There's nothing wrong with a transactional relationship when value is given for the transaction. I know that people are going to say there's value given because my content makes them feel good, but
that's the transaction.
My content is supposed to make people feel good, and it's by virtue of them feeling good that they're going to watch it and more people are going to watch it. That's the transaction, not money changing hands for me making them feel good. But let's just say we started
bankrupt.
You know what's funny, by the way, nobody can see your face, it just looks like Barney's talking.
reality is going to hit you hard like a sack of bricks.
The transactional nature is merchandising. There, everybody knows that they're supporting you for something that costs less than they're buying it for, but they get something for their contribution and they have a memento to show for it. That's what I think we got to start doing, merchandising.
What's your merchandise?
My merchandise is, because I am not the best dad ever, I am tied for first with all of the best dads in the world. When is Father's Day?
June
what?
What's like the third weekend of June.
Okay, so I think this is what we're gonna do. I'm gonna scrap the Patreon account and we are gonna go for our first round of merchandising, and it's going to be best dad ever t-shirts for Father's Day. Marion, can you order
you ordered it the first time here.
How many do we think we can sell? 1,000?
Yeah. 30,000?
No, we definitely can't sell 30,000. Let's go for 1,000?
10!
And you, how much are you, like $100 a year? It's
June 17th.
I don't know if it's, if that's a Canadian-American thing.
One month a day, we can do it. We can get a better price on these shirts if we order them more than one at a time. So, Marion, you gonna do some research? I'm scrapping Patreon. It is an amazing concept and a platform, and for anyone who's not neurotic, it probably would work. I hate when people lend me money. I hate borrowing money because I hate feeling indebted to people. The people who should be sponsoring and financing the creators are third-party advertisers through marketing or sponsors. I'm open for sponsorships.
I'm open for sponsorships.
Len Thompson. I would love to have a lure that says Viva Frei. We can split the royalties on all sales. It would sell. It would sell. Who else did I was thinking would be great? Patreon has a use, but I think it comes with too much emotional baggage. I don't want my users giving me money. I don't want them thinking they have to, and I don't want them feeling bad if they don't do it, but they know others are doing it. You are here because you love the content and Barney's butt. Look at this. Stare into it. This video's over. I had the greatest idea. A coffee mug that says coffee or Red Bull on it.
That's
not an idea. No, you didn't. Edit it out, edit it out. A t-shirt that says coffee or Red Bull.
Red Bull any day.
I just took your idea, you see what I did there? And I made it better. Holy crab apples on a t-shirt, on a mug and a t-shirt would be great.
Daddy, okay. A squirrel on a t-shirt.
So these are the ideas. Anyone else have any ideas? Oh, and you know what we're gonna do? We're gonna auction off some of the dead GoPros so that those will be like mementos. Anyone else have any ideas of things that subscribers would actually pay for that contain an essential element of our brand?
Daddy, my adhesive with money on it.
Cooking with Viva Frei aprons.
You could just put your face on an apron.
Like this.
Oh, creepy, no.
Okay, well this video's done again. Bye-bye.